Okay, we're gonna get started. We'll call the order. Department comments, Amy?
Just doing reassessment, still in Adams Township. Will be done before the end of the year, and everything's going well. Peter Bowie hearings on the 24th.
Kim?
Tax payments are starting to slowly come in.
Oh, is that time of year again?
Then we'll get slammed. Everything's fine.
Great, great, great. Sheriff?
Housing extra inmates. We brought in $208,517.50. And then reported collections, $82,981.53. And we also hired a new deputy. He started Wednesday. I was wanting to have him here to meet you guys, but he's tied up with the bridge vessel stuff, so.
What's his name?
Matt Roberts.
Good deal.
Yep.
Good deal. Questions? All right. Thank you. Stephanie?
I've presented two opioid funds, additional appropriation requests to the commissioners. The local coordinating council and the VIDEOGRAPHER have made their recommendation to approve. One is in the amount of $26,500, and that is to attend the annual conference. And those, if that will be attending, will be probation and drug court, law enforcement, Hamilton Center, and our community mentor. And that is the annual training that offers all types of, oh, and the judge will be attending as well, to get the most recent training, you know, what works and what doesn't work. And the other one is in the amount of $8,000. And this will be for the North Central Park Schools and working with the Hamilton Center to provide school groups that the schools will identify the children for these groups and work with them on skills and that sort of thing in the amount of $8,000.
Okay, go over the first one again about, I guess it sounds like an awful lot of people. You know, so go over again the numbers and some things like that, if you would please.
Okay. It's an annual training conference on addiction, mental health, and justice reform. It is the conference for networking, and it's for justice and treatment leaders, including judges, prosecutors, defense counsel, probation and parole, law enforcement, case managers, treatment providers, county and state officials, and it's on the leading what's working in treatment interventions, and they anticipate that the drug court team, probation team, will attend, in addition to the judge, Hamilton Center, with its our case managers that work with probation and drug court.
How many?
There's about 10.
10 people at $26,500?
Yes.
Where is
really?
It? Where is it?
It's in Anaheim, California.
First of all, these won't get dealt with today anyway because they haven't been published. But we really think that $26,500 to send 10 people to California, some of which are not even county employees or government employees. We're sending Hamilton Center people there?
The two case managers from Hamilton Center, our community mentor that works with probation and drug court.
Is there not a closer conference than Anaheim, California?
Well, at this conference, they change locations every year. A couple years ago, they went to, I think it was Nashville. We assisted with that, the LCC did.
How many people went into that conference?
I don't remember.
I mean, is it a rehash from 2 years ago? I mean, is it, you know, I've seen these conferences and they, you know, tends to be a lot of repetition.
Well, I think with everything that's been going on with mental health and they're trying to bring everybody together that's involved with the judicial and the case managers, probation and drug court, they're trying to bring everybody together to collaborate and work, involve everybody that has involvement.
Is this a national conference?
Yes.
All right, so you're going to send 10 people from Parke County. All right, there's 92 counties in the state of Indiana, and let's just say that that would be equivalent. Right, so you're sending almost 1,000 people from the state of Indiana. 50,000 people going to this conference? I mean, really? I mean, that's a question.
Well, I can't answer that. I would have to get Jason Carr and ask him about how many.
That's a salty number for a conference trip. A very salty number for a conference
trip. I think you need to cut down your number of people. They don't need all those people to go. One or two can go and then report back. You don't need all of those people going. So if you want to have a chance, we can't act on it today, but if you want to have a chance for this to pass here, I'd suggest you go back and you cut down the number of people that you're sending.
And then the second one with Hamilton Center, are we going to actually expect, my reports back from some of the activities at Hamilton Center, including in county government, is basically nothing ever happens through Hamilton Center. Are they going to actually do something for this $8,000?
Yes, it's they're already established in the schools, providing school groups to those students that are identified by the school counselors.
Do the school counselors agree that they are involved in the school?
Yes, it's a they have a agreement.
No. Will they openly say that the Hamilton Center is an active participant in their school at this point?
I believe so. I would need to check with the schools, but I do.
Well, I can certainly do that too. But I've heard to the opposite of that in a lot of cases. So that's why I'm asking the question.
I know that Hamilton Center is. It has been in the elementary schools and the middle school, at least last year. And the school counselors identify the students that need to participate in these groups to just help with managing assisting them with emotions and behavior.
Okay.
So when, remind me again, you probably said this, when is the conference?
The conference, I believe, is I believe it's next year.
Oh, so we have plenty of time then. I thought maybe it was coming up soon then.
She said every other year.
I think it's May of 2020.
Got plenty of time to hash this out then. Like I said, we can't make any decisions today.
Right.
That would be my recommendation, that you go back and see if we can't par that down some to something that's a little more palatable. They don't need all those people.
Okay.
So par it down, come back. Please.
Okay.
Yeah, on the other one, I know Roy's the one's got questions on that. How soon do we need to, you need an answer on that, the other one?
Well, I need to come back to the next meeting anyways to present the conference once we pare down the numbers and, you know, repay that amount. So I'll be back for that one. I know the school groups are in place now. So this helps with the materials and supplies, and it's the contract rate for to do the school groups.
Right. Well, do we want to at least advertise this? We can advertise the school one.
The 8,000.
The 8,000. We'll advertise it for next month, and that way we can act on that. Because it's not advertised, we can't really do anything.
Right.
So we'll advertise that one. We'll not advertise that other one until we have a clearer sense. It's May, so there isn't any huge rush that I see. Other than they can get their hotel reservations by the end of the year. So, we'll do that. How's that?
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Public comments. Oh, I'm sorry. Chris?
There are three things I wanted to talk to you about. The first is the EMPG salary grant. We're applying for that, and that will reimburse the county $18,450 for the salary for EMA salaries this year. If we do it every year, it's pretty easy. There's no, I hate saying it's free money because it's not, but it's the closest thing to it. The next thing is to give you an update on some of the grants that we're working. They're all going fairly well. The grant we did with the Sheriff's Department to get them new computers, that should be finished out here by, we should get the money back here in the middle of November, and that will close that out and zero balance that one. There is a grant to get, I'm working to buy radios to put auxiliary radios into the dispatch because it takes a while for them to get the radios in. It won't be done by the end of the year, or it could be done by the end of the year, but we won't get the reimbursement back from the state. So there's a possibility that you have to work alone, and I'll keep you informed of that as that's going on.
Sure.
And then the last thing would be the console. Talked to you before about us needing to buy a new console for the dispatch because ours is old and it's on its last leg. I've gotten several quotes, and I'm working with different vendors to get more of them. And right now the cost is anywhere between $200K and $600K. I'll have more information as we go on. I just wanted to keep you informed. My goal is to sign an agreement to order this by January. When we look at the money, there's two options for that money to come from. One is the balance that's in the 911 fund, which I think is almost $400,000. And then the other would be using money from the COVID, the American Recovery Act. But that's just to prepare you for the question.
Maybe we could do it, and even a combination possibly of maybe both funds or something. I mean, we wouldn't want to completely drain your 911 fund, would we? I mean, in case something.
When does the COVID money have to be spent by? Is there a timeline?
It has to be committed by the end of 24, spent by the end of 26.
Right. So maybe a combination or something. I don't know. I guess it depends on how much the bill ends up being, right? If you get it down to $200,000,
That's
okay.
It. Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Last.
I'm hoping 10 years. The one we had in here lasts probably over 15.
All right. Public comments. No minutes. Didn't quite get down. Ready to go to additionals.
NBH restricted for Randy came by and talked to me about this one, $45,000 for stone and gravel. They've gone over and they've got that much of a bill.
pretty much that much of a bill to Whitesville Mill Service and others. I don't know where all they owe, but the total was knocking on 45,000 of gravel that they owe for having expended the lion's share of their funds. And there might even be some transfers in here to deal with a couple of those. But the crossing grant for $1,027,000, that's appropriating the grant money from the state for the community crossings jobs. And I haven't a clue what this LCC one is. Yes, I do. It's in here, isn't it? This is for sending some of our, if not all of our probation officers to a conference. It was money that was originally awarded for a drug court app. Once they got the app or billed for it, they paid for it another way and still had this money left. So they had went back to the LCC and got permission to use it to go to this POPAI conference.
It's that's the Popeye conference, and that's the
Popeye.
Huh? Yeah, I guess the probation officers union, basically.
Probation Officers Professional Association of Indiana.
Yeah, I think it's the Probation Officers Union, pretty much what it boils down to.
Okay. Okay, that is what is before you.
Motion to approve.
Second. Motion been made and seconded to approve the additionals. All in favor? Transfers.
We have one for the Sheriff's Department, $12,000 from jail cook or jail officer supervisors to the jail cook, part-time jail cook. The full-time jail cook is going to be out a little while, and so there'll be more usage of part-time in there. The sheriff talked to me about if that would be okay to do that, and I stated that it would be fine, and he submitted the transfer, which is a payroll line intercategory, but it's payroll, so we obviously will do that one. And then we have a couple payroll ones here for Park and Rec, Fieldman to Gateman. Assuming just dealing with paying gate attendance and so on, and we,
he's been fully staffed with the Gateman, so it's,
yeah, and it's a hard thing for him to guess at times what that's all going to work out to be. So, and then the third one is utilities from unemployment utilities, another one that's tough to estimate. That's what we've got in front of us.
Move to approve.
Second. Motion been made and seconded to approve our transfers. All in favor?
Aye.
Pay the jury?
Make motion to pay the jury.
Second.
Motion been made and seconded to pay the jury. All in favor?
Aye.
Monthly reports. We have the cash flow statement from the auditor. It's in your packet. Moving on, Redevelopment Commission.
Did not meet.
Did not meet. Courthouse security did meet, but I was unable to attend. Planning Commission.
Yeah, we had the church camp down in Rockville Fork. They were trying to get it rezoned. And after they installed all of them, we're waiting on septic report from the state. And they were going to have to put in a very expensive mound system, which is going to be crap. But anyway. After a lot of review and a lot of discussion, we sent it on with a negative recommendation that it not be approved. Gone to zoning, and I believe zoning turned it down. Their management is just not, they're getting in over their head. I don't want to see it get in trouble. So I believe that's off the table now.
Solid waste?
We don't meet until the 25th of this month.
Okay. New business. No new business, I guess.
Old business.
No business. Are we ready to do? Are you doing team with TMLs? I assume your office is happy to do those at the Bridge Festival.
Yeah, the paint
Pam's the only one in the office right now because the rest of them are out.
Out, doing none.
They went to Mansfield and Bridgeton today.
Fun times.
Mm-hmm.
Fun times. So. Okay. Anything else from you, Marianne? Or no? Okay, anything else? Okay.
Sure.
Thanks.